I talked about gradient the last time, right? And gradient is how steep the line is, right? Now, in set one, we learned that gradient is rise over line. And I told you that if a line is this way, the gradient is up. The line is flat like that, the gradient is up. If the line is this way, the gradient is undefined. If the gradient slopes this way, it is positive gradient. And if it goes the other way, it's what? Negative gradient. Okay, class? Okay? Then I have one more thing. I have a gradient formula. That is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. It doesn't matter which point you take first. As long as you are given 2 points, you can find the gradient. Everybody okay? Can or cannot? Can, huh? Okay. Now, then, what is it that I say to put? Why is it that I insist that you must put brackets? Why is it that I insist that you must put brackets? In case the coordinates have got a negative value, you will not make a mistake. Everybody clear? Okay, then I also said one thing. Parallel lines have the same gradient. Agree? Parallel lines have the same gradient. Okay. Now, I gave you work on exercise 4A. Alright? I'm going to go through it now. I want to go through the full sketch paper first. Okay? Full sketch paper. I'm going to read the number. If you have a problem, you please raise up your hand. Okay? Full sketch paper. Okay. Question 1. A. Oh, 1A is 5. E? 5. Okay. Next. Question 4. 5. 6.
Morning school, can we have a representative from each class to come down to the area outside general office to collect the soap solution bottles as well as the paper towels for the wipe-down office? Can we have a representative from each class to come down to the general office area to collect the soap bottles as well as the paper towels for the wipe-down office?
Question 7. Okay, now I need to explain what is convenient first. I think you all know what is convenient, but you cannot explain it. Okay. Hold on. When I say 3 points are convenient, let's say A, B, C. That means the gradient is the same, but there must be a common point. If not, it cannot be convenient. They cannot be lying on the same line. For example, all of you look up here. I can say gradient of AB equals to gradient of BC. Or I can say gradient of AC equals to gradient of AB. But that's a common point, right? I can also say AC and BC. The common point is C. If I do not have a common point, that means if this is AB, this is CD, I can only prove that they are parallel. They do not lie on the same line. Do you understand? Because there's no connection. There must be a connection. Do you follow? What I mean is this, I mean it again. If I have two lines and they are parallel, like this, I can only say they are parallel, right? I cannot say they lie on the same line. Okay? Unless I can connect these two lines and make sure there's a common point either here, here, or here, then they can connect and make one straight line. Okay? So, when you want to say something is convenient, first thing you must mention is they must have the same gradient and they must have a common point. You see? There are two things. If not, they are just parallel lines. Okay, now, then I want to ask, must a common point be in the middle? No, it can be here, it can be here. Understand? As long as you can connect it and make sure it's right, then it's called convenient. Everybody okay? Alright, so the foolscap paper is okay. Alright, take out your notebook now. Okay, take out your notebook. I gave you some questions on the notebook as well. Let's take a look. Question 2. 3. 8. 9. Oh, no problem. Now, actually question 9. The opposite sides of a square must be parallel, okay? Because a square is actually a parallelogram. Do you all agree with me? Yes or no? So, who's scared? No problem. The notebook also no problem. You see any problem? No. Okay, good. Can the, now I want people to walk here and there. Can the back pass to the front? The who's scared paper. Now. Those who did not hang your 4.3 and 4.4, you give it to Jolene as corrections.
Combine or fix it to 3, 6, 3 is 11.
11.7 units. Now, the number is units, it's not cm, because it depends on the scale. You understand? So I just give it as units. Okay, now, some people will say, oh, you see, I do not want to take in that order. Is it okay? Yeah, it's totally fine. I can take 6, right? Minus 4, right? Okay, so I have 6 plus 4 square, right? Minus. I go the other way. Minus 5, minus 1. So I will have 10 square minus negative 6 square. So it's a plus, right? This is it. Plus, right? So this is still a 1.36. So you still get 11.7 units. Do you understand? So it doesn't matter. But what is the thing that you think you will make mistake? The plus and minus. Can you see? You have to be careful. Now, if you want, you can do it this way. That's what I always do. Something minus something squared plus something minus something squared. I add that. Then I will never make mistake because I will just plug in the number. Everybody here, but use another bracket as well. Everybody okay? And what? Another possible mistake is this is a what? Plus. It's not a minus. It's a plus because it's Pythagoras theorem. Okay. All right. So are you okay with this particular formula? Are you okay with this particular formula? Yes or no? Yes or no? Okay. Huh? All right. Now then. Let us look at example 4. Okay, example 4.
Agree?
easier to expand later. Okay, so I will get 9 a squared minus 2ab plus b squared equals to 1. Now, remember I told you negative squared is positive. So I will get 36 plus 12c plus c squared. Again, plus. Now, I want to shape. So, c is gone. Negative 16c equals to what? 37 minus 13. What's 37 minus 13? 20? 24. Did I make a mistake? Is it correct? 37 minus 13. So C will be 24 over negative 16, right? I divide by 8, what do I give me? 3 over negative 2. So it's negative 1.5, correct? Can you see that? So what is the coordinate of C? What is the coordinate of C? C will be 0, negative 1.5, right? Everybody okay here? Now, I have not finished the question. Look at the question. What did it say? Hence, find the area of triangle ACO where O is the origin. Okay, I want everyone to look here. This is where students are. They go wrong, they will go on when you in as you learn the formula. All of you are going to apply the formula, which is very stupid. Okay, this is a very easy question. Now, they tell you A is minus 3, 2. So A is somewhere here, right? Do you agree?
Yes.
Where is O? O is the origin, so it's here, right? Where is C? 0, what? Somewhere here, right? This is my C, this is my O. So it's a triangle like this, right? Find the area, right? Now, can someone tell me what's the area of a triangle? What is the formula? Half times what? Base times height. Okay, I want everyone to look here. Do you agree this is the base?
Yes.
Do you agree this is the height?
Yes.
Okay, so area of triangle, ACO, only what? Half times. Now, what is the length here? Length. This is 1.5, right? Not negative, the length. So half times 1.5, right? Times. Now what is this thing?
3.
Do you agree it's 3?
Yes.
Can you see it? If half times base times height, it's always good to sketch out, understand? Then you can see. Do you follow? So half times base times height. So this will give me a right. 9 over 4. 2, 1 quarter, unit square. You must put unit square, it's not cm square. Understand now? Because it is units, you don't know what unit is it. Understand what I'm talking about? So, I repeat. If you have this way, it's always half base times height. Now, let me just show you. Because this half base times height thing will lead us to find the shortest distance later on. Now, I'm going to ask you one more question. Let me just draw you another diagram and that's it. No homework for today, huh?
Yes.
You need to be so happy, no? You should know that the next day we have a lot, right?
Every day.
Every day, no? So poor thing, but I can't help you. Now, if I have this triangle, this is a horizontal line. How would I find the area?
Give us the points first.
I'll give you the point. Okay. Supposing this is 2, 3. This is 5, 3.
3, 3.
From here to here is how much?
3.
3. How about here?
3.
Also 3, right? So what's the area of this triangle?
Half times
3. Half times 3 and up to 3. So you must know. Do you understand what I'm talking about? Okay, you must know because we do not use the length formula every time to find length. You can also use area of triangle. I will tell you why the next lesson. Would that be okay, class? Okay. Alright, that's it for today. No time already. What is your next lesson? Oh, English. That's very good.